you like to play first? Absolutely. Would you like to mulligan? Absolutely. You should mulligan pretty much any 7-card hand that doesn't have a way to get an Enchantress. This is a 6-card hand. I can Green Sun Zenith for an Enchantress, so I'm going to be happy to keep this one. I need to draw a land next turn to get it, be able to Green Sun Zenith for an Enchantress, so there's certainly a lot of things that can go wrong with this hand. One of the things you want to do when you play this deck is always try to avoid putting land enchantments onto dual lands so they can't be wastelanded. That's the reason I didn't get a tropical island. I do not like the way this game is starting off for me. If he's some sort of combo deck playing Gataxian Probe, I'm just not going to be able to do anything at all to interact. If this is a Rug Delver deck, I'm going to be pretty tight on mana, so it's going to be hard to get the Green Sun Zenith to resolve. This could be maybe it's just a show and tell deck. This doesn't seem like a hand that could beat a show and tell deck, but it's more promising than the alternatives. Alright, that was not what I wanted to draw. This is a storm deck. It's certainly either storm or some sort of sneak and show deck, given that he's played Lotus Petal. It's strange that he has Verdant Catacombs in his deck. I don't know what kind of deck wants to play Lotus Petal and Verdant Catacombs. Well, this is obviously a storm deck now. Still think the Verdant Catacombs is pretty strange. A little bit light on sideboard options for Storm. Assuming this is ad nauseum, and I should definitely be dead. Open this up so you can see. Make it past flames. I think I'm dead at this point. I think you can just. Ritual, passing flames. Replay all the rituals, infernal tutor for 10 bucks and I die. I guess he hit another. He can't cast infernal tutor. He can cast grim tutor. So I guess he's gonna go passing flames. Replay all the rituals, cast grim tutor for. Tendrils and Kilmer. In the past, I have tried sideboarding cards like Arcane Library or Arcane Laboratory in this matchup. Or I used to have a little bit of white in my deck so I could play a Gaddock Teague. I don't have any of those things today, so I'm just going to be relying on Mindbreak Traps. Yeah, I'm dead by quite a lot. Alright, this is not a good matchup. Tormod's Crypt does a little bit. Compost does a little bit. I didn't see Burning Wishes, I only saw Past in Flames. So I don't think I'm going to board in Chill. I usually don't have very many of the red rituals. Mindbreak Traps I obviously want to board in. Nothing. Energy Field does not prevent loss of life, so that's not going to be good. Jace is a possibility. I'm going to leave a couple Elephant Grasses in my deck, just because they can stop Empty the Warrens. Seal of Primordium I don't think does anything. I don't think I really... Well, the question is Jace better or worse than Eidolon of Blossoms? Eidolon of Blossoms does sort of advance my game plan. I'm hesitating to cut Seal of Removal just because even though he doesn't have any creatures, it can bounce my Cloud of Fairies and it can bounce my Eternal Witness, which is both pretty good interactions. I'm going to cut one of them though, or I could just cut a Jace. I think I'm going to cut the Jace. The only way the Jace is really going to wind up doing something is if I, like, get him with a Mindbreak Trap, and then I get Jace out, and I get to slowly lock him up with it. I think my game plan is basically hope to either win very quickly, which my deck can... I can... It's not that hard to set up a situation where I'm winning on, like, turn 4.